in the street, they call it murder.
Alright, so Senthil, now that you've shown us your very unique vehicles, most of which are quite old, right? So from the looks of it, you like vintage, old school vehicles. So there's the Lambrettas, there's the RDs, there's a Volkswagen Beetle. These are all like, you know, from the 70s. So what, like in your journey so far with your passion for automobiles, where do you see this going in the future? Like what do you think that you want to get next or do next?
Not too sure about where design and art would lead me, but wherever it does, it moves towards a segment of my interest, which a newfound interest that I would have had. So it could be even electric bikes, or it could be converting vans into camper vans, or anything. You know, it depends upon
right.
where the road takes.
Okay. Awesome. Senthil, will you show us your camper van?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So I'll just give you like a small walk around of his camper van. This is Senthil's truck. So he uses it to transport these bikes when he's got to go for shows or events. Wow, massive.
Oh, he's washing it, huh?
Yeah, he's washing it, I think.
Yeah, or? I think he's washing it.
Oh, okay. Senthil, tell us a little bit about this model, this, you know, some details.
Yeah, this is the latest model from Force Motors.
Okay.
It's called Urbania, which they launched in Jan of this year.
2024.
Yeah.
Okay.
2024. So it's the first time it's been launched in India, and it's a monocoque chassis. It's not a ladder frame or a hitch chassis. It's because they have collaborated with Mercedes-Benz.
Force has collaborated
with Benz. The design is moreover Sprinter. Mercedes Sprinter.
Okay.
They've taken the entire body line and structures, and the internals and all are of the Mercedes Sprinter, which is a famous camper van that is available in most of the countries across the world.
Yeah, yeah,
in Europe, in US, UK.
Okay, awesome. What are you thinking when you bought this?
I was thinking I need a camper van, and oh shit, it's available in India now. Let's make a camper van. So that's the.
And how are you using it? So I know you use it to move the bikes around, to take it for events and for drag races and shows and stuff.
Yeah.
But you also use it as a family car?
I use it as a family car, because it's all interchangeable. I can change roles with it quite easily. So taking the entire family to Munnar and stuff, it did great even in the mountains. So it does good for extremely hot situations. You're just sitting inside and you can peacefully sit. There's enough headroom to stand up and walk around inside your own vehicle. And that's the biggest point that I had in mind when I said, okay, let's freeze on this and pick this up. Instead of picking up a Toyota Innova or a
other MUV,
larger seven-seaters.
Right.
So it's just the headroom space that makes a lot more things happen because of the height of the vehicle.
Right. So there's a lot of headroom, and I think you used the last time you used it for the bikes was Taneja.
Yeah, in Taneja also I took it and went for the race.
For
track.
The drag, right? Yeah. Right.
So all the bikes that you see also, they either go to the race strip or they go to events like India Bike Week or other events. I take it in the van, display it, let people have a look at the project that I made, bring it back.
All right. So this is Senthil's. You had a 207 before this, right?
Yeah.
And you still have it.
Yeah, I do it.
So Senthil used to use that before. Now he uses this. This is a serious upgrade. Senthil, can you show us inside?
Yeah, sure. He's cleaning it at the moment, but yeah, please.
Wow. So this is where the bike would come in, right?
Yeah, this is where the bikes would come in.
Would you need to take off the seat?
No, the wheel will come till here.
Oh, the wheel will come till here. All right. So
it fits with the seats.
Okay.
What was 11 seater? I made a four seater out of.
Okay. Amazing. So this is how the cockpit is.
Yeah, all black.
All black. Senthil, is that your favorite color?
Black? Yeah, man. Black is my favorite. But none of my bikes are black.
Yeah. I've noticed. I think you prefer the four wheelers black, huh?
Yeah.
So that's the console.
Which brand do you suggest?
Well, I drive a Hyundai, and that's my.
It's got
favorite.
A multimedia system.
Test drive a Hyundai.
The gear shift is here.
Yep.
Wow. What size engine is this, Senthil?
This is a 2.6 liter turbo diesel. Putting out 140 bhp and 370 nm of torque.
Okay.
That isn't too much, but it isn't too less either.
Okay. It's balanced. 1800 2122. Nice, amazing. And you've got like this has got complete air conditioning, so
yeah,
you can
complete
see
air conditioning. All the windows apart from the front passenger windows, all are sealed windows, so there's very less loss of AC air once running. So this is the AC control for the rear.
Okay.
Completely a separate AC system for the rear.
Right.
And for the front also, there's a separate one.
Crazy, yeah. So just to give you an idea of the space, I'm gonna go right to the back and show you how big this mini bus is.
So there's one thing I can show you from there.
Oh wow.
So this is a swivel seat that I designed, where I can utilize the maximum space if the seat is able to turn. So this is a system that comes from the JCB,
okay,
where it lets the seat to swivel and it has a locking mechanism to keep it in place. So both of them actually have.
Okay.
As it may sound quite dangerous to have it on the driver's side, but I do. Yeah.
So Senthil, tell me something. This feature comes as standard on this vehicle?
On the JCB.
So this doesn't come with the force?
No, it doesn't come with the force.
Oh wow. How did you do this? How did you like? Did you get it done outside or did they?
It was just an idea a friend gave. I was looking for swivel plates.
Right.
As you know, abroad it's very easily available for camper vans. You just tell the brand of camper van and aftermarket swivel seats for the front seats are available. But in India, it was just not possible for me to get my hands on it. So I designed it from the JCB's platform. The JCB has swivel seats in their vehicles, and I took that system and I integrated it into the existing seats from the Urbania.
Okay. Oh wow. And who did you get this fit outside then, Senthil? This is done.
No, I've done all this basically in-house.
Okay.
So this is the stage that it is reached where I'm just checking whether it is all perfect. All of it will be raw metal at the moment.
Okay, got it.
Once I know that there is absolutely no flaw and it is working fine, there's no issue, and then I remove the entire thing and I either get it powder coated or spray painted black to match the rest of the.
So this is your own, again, this is your own customization.
Yeah. All right.
Wow. That's pretty crazy, huh? So just those two seats will, these don't.
Yeah.
These two.
So these two, when you turn both of them around, this becomes like a conference of sorts, and in the future there's going to be a press down table which with the X stand comes up.
Okay.
So there would be a table here.
Okay.
All four people could either sit and eat or discuss or have a good time in this. This whole space becomes usable in a standing condition of the vehicle with AC and the music systems and
stuff. Wow, okay. So yeah, this is like going to be. So this is your vision of a camper, and obviously you have like a lot of other mods that you have.
We've just gotten started with this much, but now I'm just figuring out what we could do best with the rest space. Of the space.
Right. What is this, Senthil?
These are condensers, as in AC condensing vents this thing. Okay. It's just not a blower, but there is a condenser inside it for to give AC. As you can see, all those are the vents for it. These are the lights here. There is a lot of difference from a normal TT to this
tempo traveler.
Yeah, from a tempo traveler to this. As you can see, all they have individual lights. They have individual AC vents which can move and which you can close.
Control, right?
And you have.
And is this a USB socket?
No, that is to save our souls.
Oh, okay.
Those are the USB sockets almost in for every location.
Right, here there's another one.
There in the front of that side. Right. So there's a lot of this thing. And this is the sliding door that was never available in India. It was the first time that they have introduced this. So as you can see, all of these are electric points which go and
connect.
Go into connect by pressure.
Oh, okay. Oh,
it has lights and it has certain electronics, even though the door is in a running condition.
Okay.
So all of these are the kinds of mods that you don't see in our Indian made vehicles.
Right. So Senthil, you did a trip with your family recently, right? So he uses this to do trips, camping trips with his family, just travel around the country, and also transport his vehicles. And this can actually seat. So there is room for more seats, right?
Yeah, there would have been 11 seats. So there would have been another 2 here, another 4 at the dead end, and another 1 where you are standing.
Oh, okay. So yeah. But obviously, you don't need that many seats.
Yeah, I won't need that many seats.
All right, awesome. Very nice, Senthil.
Oh man, I put this thing called what do you call this?
That's
boost.
That's a diesel tronic, right?
No. Diesel tronic is what I had, and it didn't make a great deal of difference.
Oh,
but,
okay. This is from Pete's.
Got boost. GOTBOOST.
Got boost. Okay.
Got boost or wind booster.
Okay.
Abroad, it's called wind booster.
Okay.
But the Indian version, someone who's making it in Delhi.
Okay.
With the Chinese parts being imported, has renamed his product as Got Boost.
Got Boost.
And this is fucking mad. It is.
Yeah.
It's just mad.
Wow. Okay. So what is it? What does it do, Senthil? So you have
it,
maps.
It doesn't. It has maps and it doesn't mess around with the ECU.
Okay.
Actually, even for a stock vehicle, you could put this on, and this clips on into the accelerator pedal.
Okay.
Now most of the vehicles are they don't have wires. They don't have cables. It's all ride by wire.
Yeah.
So there'll just be a male to female coupler. You remove that coupler. Just put this one, which has a small little electronic set to it, and then again the male female to it.
Got it.
And your entire vehicle changes completely. You have modes in which you can select for race, for the way it revs, for the time, how quickly you want the turbo to open, how much of lag you want to give.
Oh, you think?
Yeah, even valet. If you're going to give it for valet, you can just put it in valet mode, and that guy can't really push your engine limit.
Okay.
But when you want to push your engine limit, there are different modes, and it works very well. Works too good, and I'm suggesting all of my friends to pick it up, because in this vehicle, if it can work so well, it works like brilliantly in some of the cars and the latest cars and the bikes.
Right. So this is the console, right?
Yeah.
So how do you control the map, Senthil, on this? Or there are buttons there?
There are buttons there, and it is a phone app as well.
Oh, okay.
So in the phone app also, I haven't logged on into it. I had to just scan one thing to log into it.
Okay.
But anyway, since the entire thing is even a...
Right,
there is
two buttons. Right.
This thing. So button up and button down, like from race.
So right now it's in race. Okay.
Yeah.
Drag. Oh,
drag.
Wow. AI. AI.
Valet.
Off-road.
Eco. Learner. Rally.
Wow. It's got a lot of boost. Okay.
Yeah, boost.
So this is the turbo controlling bit. Okay.
Oh wow. So it controls the accelerator. So it manipulates the ECU to thinking that that the vehicle is already moving.
Okay, got it. So it's kind of like in bikes, what you have like TPS, like a, throttle like position
a,
sensor?
Like somewhat like a quick throttle of sorts.
Right.
But yeah.
Okay.
But awesome. But with the ECU, it works a lot differently.
Okay.
So previously, if I had to get the engine to rev this much, the amount of pedal that I needed to press was a lot more, two times more than right now. So right at the moment, if I just touch the accelerator pedal, it's already starting to rev up.
Okay.
So it changes the entire response of the throttle response.
And
completely messes around with the throttle response to make it a lot more
to give you what you want. You know how you demand it.
Yeah.
Like, awesome.
Actually, a super product.
How did you find out about this, Senthil?
Online from Instagram. I saw a few posts and I just followed the posts.
Okay.
And saw that there were actual human beings who were testing it out, and this guy, the owner, was taking the videos of their reactions when they put the turbo boost and drive their vehicles in.
So usually we hear about Pete's and we hear about Dieseltronic, right? From Race Dynamics. And
so I got the Dieseltronic put into it.
Right, I remember last time you told me.
This thing a little. Quotient has been upped a little.
Okay.
But this is a whole different story.
Okay, so you're much happier with
this.
Oh, awesome. And in terms of costing, is there a big difference between both of them?
Actually, both of them are the same price.
Okay.
That's also around 20. This is also around 20.
Okay. The Dieseltronic is a piggyback, right?
It's a piggyback kind of ECU.
Okay, it connects into this. Doesn't really connect into
this.
ECU?
Does not connect to the
ECU at all.
ECU at all.
Okay, this manipulates only the throttle position, the acceleration, right?
The acceleration of it.
Okay, awesome. And you find any difference in mileage or anything like that?
Mileage has dropped a little, but
because you're using
good.
As in the performance
it's
mode,
it's giving
right?
me the better performance and taking a little mileage. It's okay than having a sluggish vehicle and
correct, struggling.
Yeah,
with such a it's quite a big vehicle also to maneuver. How different is it to drive, Senthil? Since you've like this is a big, much bigger vehicle compared to.
Since I've been driving it pretty regularly to office and back and stuff like that, it's almost like driving a SUV. So for me, it's just like driving an SUV, but I think others would find it a little
Learning curve.
Yeah.
Steep learning curve.
But all the controls and the things are extremely good. The clutch is like butter soft. The steering is also really soft. The gear knob is right there and there's no long throw and stuff like that. So
okay.
it's very easy to play around with.
Okay, awesome, Senthil. When I had first seen this with Senthil, I thought maybe he's going to turn this into like a mobile kind of tattoo parlor.
Yeah, it plays multiple roles.
Maybe outreach for people in. The quality is just amazing, right, Senthil, in this?
Yeah, seriously.
So what plans do you have in the future with this? Like what are you actively looking at?
I'm planning to keep it as a multi-role player at the moment. So when I want to take family, it should be able to
do that
and have a small little kitchenette. Have a this is a chemical loop, by the way. I'm going to get that installed in a certain spot.
Okay.
And have a cover for it with a vent.
Okay.
So the loo is going to be like a normal for whatever other mods are going to come in and go.
Right.
But definitely a loo could be the same, considering I have two daughters and.
So Senthil travels around with his kids. So you have sleep. So right now at this moment you travel with sleeping bags and tents that you then pitch.
Could, yeah.
But eventually you could probably
make this an extension. Fixed bedding system.
Right.
Which could be bolted off and taken out, and then I could put my bikes in. Which can be even bolted on, taken off, and then I can put another setting in.
Okay.
So like that, like a multi-changeable setting is what I have in mind.
It's awesome. All right. This is these are some of Senthil's vehicles. Mm-hmm. He's got another Skeletor RD in his tattoo parlor in Indranagar. Thank you so much, Senthil. Thanks for your time. And thanks for breaking it down for us and taking us through your journey. Yeah? Thank you so much. All right.